By now, we are probably all aware that Disney will be launching the streaming service Disney Plus in November 2019. They will air most of their shows and others from various productions, but the streaming service will also have new shows, including Lizzie McGuire. There's some exciting news around the reboot of the show, so stick around to find out more. But before we begin, subscribe to Riveted for this and more amazing videos. First of all, we're getting serious 13 going on 30 vibes here, and we're not complaining about it. Lizzie was 13 years old when we first met her, and now she's 30. Well, instead of a two-hour movie, Lizzie McGuire will air for a couple of episodes and probably seasons. After the reboot was revealed in August, Duff expressed her relief with her Instagram followers with a video and captioned it. Surprise! I've been trying to contain this excitement for a long time while this has been in the works. I am beyond excited to be home again, back with my girl and into her 30s. Many of her fans were very excited that she's coming back, and they expressed their joy in the comments. Lizzie was totally relatable when she was 13, and we bet she will also be relatable in her 30s. For those who are still wondering what the fuss is all about, let's take you back a little bit. In 2001, fans were introduced to Lizzie McGuire and her family as she tried to navigate her life through middle school. The series followed Lizzie McGuire, a 13-year-old girl who dreams of being popular at school, with the help of her best friends Miranda and Gordo. Episodes centered on Lizzie's life, dealing with her family, mostly her parents Joe and Sam, and her younger brother Matt, and normal teenage life stuff. Lizzie had an animated alter ego that represented her feelings. The show aired two seasons on the Disney Channel from 2001 to 2004, ending with Lizzie on her middle school trip to Italy before heading off to high school. It's not surprising that Disney would want to revive the original TV series. The series won Favorite TV Show at the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards in 2002 and 3. A film based on the show, the Lizzie McGuire movie, debuted on May 2, 2003, at number 2 at the box office behind X2 X-Men United. It earned $42.7 million at the American box office and eventually grossed $55.6 million worldwide. The movie was based on Lizzie and her classmates going on a school trip to Rome, Italy, where Lizzie finds love, fame, and trouble in unexpected places. And that was the last time we had heard anything about Lizzie for quite some time. Talks of reviving the show actually started many years back, but it was never the right time. In 2014, Hilary Duff announced that she would be open to a Lizzie McGuire reunion. A few years later, the crew finally decided that it was the right time to bring back the show. And Hilary isn't the only person reprising her role on the show. While announcing the series, the creator said, "Just like there is no Lizzie McGuire without Hilary Duff, there is no McGuire family without Hallie, Robert, and Jake. The original series holds a special place in the hearts of so many, and we can't wait to introduce fans, both old and new, to an older, wiser, yet still perfectly imperfect Lizzie." So, the original cast members Hallie Todd, Robert Carradine, and Jake Thomas are set to reprise their roles as Joe, Sam, and Matt McGuire on the upcoming Disney Plus sequel series, joining previously announced star Hilary Duff as Lizzie. It's one big happy family all over again, and everyone is excited, especially for those who grew up watching Lizzie McGuire as kids. The remarkable team has already started working on the show, and Hilary Duff shared the first look. The cast of the hit Disney Channel comedy convened for the first time in 15 years for a read-through of the first episode of the sequel. Lizzie is even blonder than she was when she was 13. The mom looks pretty much the same. The dad is very, very different, and Matt has a mustache. To ensure that the show won't lose the touch it had over a decade ago, the new Lizzie McGuire comes from the original series creator Terry Minsky and the Disney Channel. Okay, one of the major questions everyone is having is what will happen in the new Lizzie McGuire, which is different from the original? For starters, Lizzie is no longer living in the suburbs, where the action of the OG Lizzie McGuire took place. The news story picks up as Lizzie McGuire is just about to turn 30. She seemingly has it all: her dream job as an assistant to a fancy New York City decorator, her dream guy, and a picturesque Brooklyn apartment. But things aren't always as they seem. With a little help from her friends, her loving family, and her 13-year-old alter ego in animated form, Lizzie navigates the ups and downs of adulthood. Though she has a seemingly perfect job working for a successful designer, her dream Brooklyn apartment, and an awesome boyfriend, not everything is as great as it seems in Lizzie's life. So far, she's still very relatable to most people living between their late 20s and early 30s. The question now is, will Lizzie's besties Miranda, played by LaLanne, and Gordo, played by Adam Lambert, be back for the reboot? The last time viewers saw Miranda was at their middle school graduation, and she went to Mexico with her family instead of attending the school trip. If she does come back, audiences would love to see what she did with her life and if she and Lizzie are still close. LaLanne Vergara Paris, who played Lizzie's fashionable bestie, has worked on various web series and currently has a feature in post-production, according to IMDb. Unlike Lambert, she did not appear in the Lizzie McGuire movie. Adam Lambert's last known screen role was in 2008. Lizzie has a boyfriend in the new series, and he's a restaurateur who owns a spot in Soho. Well, that means she will not be with Gordo in the reboot. Hilary was a bit disappointed that the relationship ended, but she hopes that Adam will somehow be involved in the reboot. He was a very special piece of the original show, and erasing him completely will be a big injustice. Many people who didn't watch the series in the early 2000s will probably want to watch the show to be up to date. Well, Disney has more good news for this lot. All 65 Lizzie McGuire episodes will be available to stream on Disney Plus when it launches in the US on November 12th. Those who may have forgotten about the action will also have the opportunity to binge-watch the show before moving on to experience when Lizzie is 30. Hillary has already attended a couple of interviews to talk about the show. Although she's not giving away all the good stuff, she had this to say. "For me, coming back when she's 30 and she's not in a marriage and she's not having a baby and she's not doing all the things that I have already done in my life, that story is really exciting for me," the 32-year-old actress told E! News on October 12th. "I think to myself, where can we go? What are the struggles of a 30-year-old right now? What are the pressures that life throws in front of a woman who is 30 and doesn't have all the things yet? The opportunities are really endless. Maybe at the end of the series, we see her having a baby? You know, maybe it's hard for her to get pregnant? Maybe there is something bad happening on her 30th birthday in the first episode? Maybe she's going to be in her childhood bedroom in the first episode? I don't know. There's all this fun. We want to give fans what they want, but we also want to have a completely new show." Most of her fans are happy that Lizzie doesn't have kids at 30. They simply want to relate to a 30-year-old without children. Plus, we already have Raven's home taking care of that perspective. For Hillary, it will be an exciting journey because she has a baby in real life, but the show, she plays a 30-year-old without a baby. As mentioned earlier, the new show will exclusively air on Disney Plus. So if you weren't planning on signing up for Disney's equivalent of Netflix, I can guarantee you will be now. On November 12th, the streaming service will launch in the US, Canada, Netherlands, with Australia and New Zealand going live a week later on the 19th. Unfortunately, there's still no confirmed date for the UK and other countries. Disney already released an epic 3-hour trailer of all the movies and shows that will be available on the service in the coming months. Subscribers will also get access to movies and exclusive new live-action Star Wars and Marvel Cinematic Universe spin-offs. If you're wondering how much it will cost to keep up with Lizzie McGuire in her 30s, we've broken it down for you. Don't worry, Disney has definitely considered its audience, and the cost isn't much. In the US, a month-by-month flat subscription to sign up for Disney Plus will cost $6.99 a month. Nice and straightforward, but there's a savings plan if you go for Disney's 12-month option, with a year subscription costing $69.99 for the year. That's $5.83 per month. In case you're not sure whether you want to join the streaming service, there's a 7-day free trial before subscription. The good news for Verizon customers in the States is that subscribers to its 4G LTE 5G Unlimited Wireless or Fios Home Internet services will get a free year subscription to Disney+. Disney will also be offering a bundle package of Disney+, along with its two other streaming services, Hulu and ESPN+, for a knockdown $12.99 a month. That's $5 cheaper than subscribing to all three separately. In Canada, Disney Plus will cost $8.99 per month, Australians will pay $8.99 per month, and the subscription cost in New Zealand will be $9.99 per month. It was also confirmed that there can be 4 concurrent streams at once, which means 4 people can watch Disney Plus at the same time with 1 basic account. Wow, Disney, you clearly didn't come to joke. This is a better deal compared to other streaming services such as Netflix and Hulu. Many fans are probably wondering what will happen to Younger, and there's more good news. Fans of Younger have nothing to worry about. Duff is reportedly going to juggle her role as Lizzie and that of Kelsey Peters on her other hit show. The one thing most people love about Hillary Duff is that for her, it's never really about money. She genuinely wants to entertain and relate with her audience. Are you excited that Hillary and the other cast members from Lizzie McGuire are back? Let us know your thoughts and expectations in the comments section below. Remember, we publish amazing videos daily. This has been Riveted.